this is something that came across my radar. I actually had the honor of interviewing the founder and creator of ngrok, Alan Shreve, earlier this morning. And ngrok is a, if you haven't heard about ngrok, it's a tool, stands for basically network grok. And what ngrok does is it allows you to basically have Ingress as a service. It's a tool that's it's fantastic. It basically, the way that most developers think of ngrok today is they think of like, I want something to expose to the outside world from my developer machine. This is typically how developers think of ngrok. And so I'll run ngrok on a command line, and this will open up a port for me in a safe and secure tunnel, and then expose that to the outside world. So the statement, it works on my machine, actually rings true because people can see it. But ngrok is so much more than that. It's basically providing turnkey integrations with things like, earlier today, Alan was telling me and showing me the ability to turn on OAuth integration, the ability to do Ingress really easy on home, so many different services. It is an immensely powerful tool. The whole reason why I mention this is because recently they've added ngrok-go, which is an Ingress for your Go apps. And the reason why they do this is because, and they're doing this also for Rust and for JavaScript and for .NET, etc. And so the whole reason why they do this is because there's a bunch of facilities that you want to set up as Ingress. So here's an example. This is basically where you start your program in Go. And don't worry about the semantics of this. This is, if you were to do a mental search or replace of, let's provision some kind of endpoint receiver, this is what this does, and then allows you to receive it using the HTTP infrastructure. That's all this does. But then this is the really powerful part. Notice here, we're just wiring up configuration. So it says, I want to allow this domain, or I want to enable OAuth with GitHub. You just wire those in, and it does all that management for you. So it does Ingress services, allowing you to do any of this stuff very, very simply through one line of code, basically. And so this is a framework that's available, a library that's available that allows you to do all these things and just turn on or off these facilities if you're utilizing ngrok as part of your stack, which I think is fantastic. And so Ingress is basically a high-level abstraction. And this is the statement that Alan made to me this morning, which I thought really resonate. Developers are forced to work with their network stack as if it's like an assembly level language of networking. It's like, it's too hard. I have to set this up, set that up, set up verbs, set up receivers, allow this IP address range, do this OAuth, do that OAuth, whatever. And now if you just integrate ngrok, you simply just wire it up and it does it all for you magically, which is fantastic. So this is a library I'm immensely excited to get my hands on. This was announced last week, and Alan gave me the sort of details about that, which will be in an upcoming interview of Inside DevOps. Shameless plug there. There you go.
That's really interesting, because I've used ngrok exactly the way you described, right? Like,
yep,
something's working on my machine. I want to hook up my mate's UI to the API running on my machine, right?
Yep.
But this is something else. This is like, yeah.
So this isn't your dad's ngrok. Ngrok has evolved. Ngrok. Yeah. So the way that I think most people think of ngrok these days is the 6-7-year-old definition of ngrok, where it was just a way of piercing the firewall through a secure tunnel, etc. But it's evolved way, way past that. So now it's built-in security, turnkey observability. So there's lots of capabilities
it's
there.
Production services now as well.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. And it's also a Ingress controller for Kubernetes as well. So there's lots and lots of stuff in here. And so basically this is the way this,
clarity.
I know. Yeah. So this is the way they start. It's take it from development. This is the typical scenario that people think of. You fire up ngrok, you want to expose your local directory via port 3000, and then you can configure it. They also have a Terraform provider. So that was cool. I didn't realize they had a Terraform provider as well. So they basically have evolved the platform in a huge way. And now it is at a point where it is getting really, really awesome. And so I was really keen to talk to Alan, and we had a great conversation this morning. So again, subscribe to our YouTube channel. You will find our interview there, hopefully in the future. So another shameless plug. I'm okay with that.